We'll be talking about the steps involved in doing effective wealth management. This is what we follow. This is our procedure, how we manage wealth. Wealth management is a professional service which is a combination of financial planning, risk management, asset allocation, tax planning, accounting and compliances, and legacy planning. It's a combination of all this. When I talk about financial planning, it is all about understanding our client. Luckily, all our clients are very old clients. We have long-term relations with our client. But we always, even for the new client, the first step is to understand the client, why he wants to invest, why he wants to build a corpus. There may be multiple reasons: building retirement corpus, child education, marriage, investment in house, and building a corpus. So first we understand what is the objective of investment. Then understanding and preparing the long-term and short-term cash flow of the client. What are his income? How much income will he earn? What are the expenses? When he wants to go to the holidays and everything. So we understand, we make a chart of his long-term and short-term cash flow. Then understanding the existing wealth. It is very important to understand what he has now and what he wants to achieve. Then regular reviews within the organization and with the client. Within the organization, we have a research process, we sit together, we work out what kind of risk profile we have to make for the client, and then we regularly review on it. Risk management, which is a very important part of financial planning or wealth management planning. We analyze the risk appetite of the client. This is done by seeing his age, the present and future earning parameters, quantum of overall wealth, committed outflows, dependence on others, on him or her, and the nature and mindset of the client. Nature and mindset of the client is very important. We have to provide psychological peace to the client. The wealth, all about Mr. Jain's presentation will be, you know, investing through peace and achieving peace from the investment. It should not disturb his, you know, night sleep or something. So this is how we establish what will be the risk profile of the client. How much he has to invest in equity, how much he has to invest in debt. I'll be talking about it in my next slide. Asset allocation. A person with a low risk. We have made a model portfolio which can be different from client to client, but we say 30% property for a low risk person. Debt instruments of 35%, which includes fixed deposits, FMPs, bonds, liquid funds, the bank balance, the MIP scheme, they can constitute 35%. Equity, mutual funds and shares 30%, and other commodities, international fund, gold, etc. can be 5%. This kind of model will ensure that even if the equity market is down long term, in our other presentation we'll be talking about that equity is not an investment for long term, but in short term also, if the person has a very low risk appetite, this kind of model can be made for a low risk profile person. A medium risk, property will be 25%, debt instruments will be 25%, equity can go up to 45%. And other investments, may it be commodities or international funds, etc., can go to 5%. Then a high-risk person can go 60% into equity. Debt is 15%, property 20%, and then other investments 5%. So this is this has to be changed with client to client, but this is one of the model asset allocation. Then review. An integral part of wealth management is the continuous review against projected returns, what we plan, what we are getting, against standard indexes for equity, Nifty and Sensex. Restructuring of asset classes according to client's need. It is not that once the plan is made, we have to review and keep on changing, because there can be a change in client's risk profile, his psychology, against prevailing macro environment. Because we are in a dynamic environment situation, if we are expecting our country will grow at 8%, we are bullish on equity. If we feel our government and other things are not favorable, we may reduce the equity exposure also. Now this slide shows investing early and how investing early and saving consistently help. This is a slide on power of compounding. When you start early, saving early and continue this till a substantial amount of period, you can earn more in a form of interest. The example shows Mr. X, who has invested 4,000 per month for 35 years. The total amount invested was 16,80,000. At 15% return became 4.23 crores at the age of 45. But a person, Mr. Y, who started investing 8,000 per month for 25 years and invested 24 lakhs became only 2.04 crores. So this is a power of compounding. Start early and you can see the result. Then we are talking about pros and cons of various asset classes. Like property, the positives are income is in the form of rental payments, which is a regular income. It is less volatile compared to investment in shares. The capital growth is capital growth if value of property holding increases. But the negatives are it is not liquid, it is difficult to manage. For debt instruments, bonds, they give regular interest income, they give higher returns than FDs, but the interest rate fluctuations are there in bonds and they are very less liquid. Nowadays, they are traded on NSE platform, but still sometimes you don't get the buyers. Fixed deposits give regular interest income, but are very low post-tax returns. They are not tax efficient. And early maturity also has a cost. ICDs, inter-corporate loan, interest rates are high, but there's always a risk of default. Debt mutual fund, they are highly liquid, their long-term taxation is long, has indexation benefits. But the negatives are the return may vary, there's a default risk, which is very less, but there is, and there can be an interest rate risk also. Gold, liquidity, if it is brought in the form of ETFs, but they again have the price fluctuations. But equity mutual fund, if you see, a lot of positives are there. The best investment option to achieve good long-term returns. Managed by professional fund managers. Less volatile as compared to shares. Liquid as money comes in a bank in 3 days. No long-term capital gains. And the NAV is updated on a daily basis. So we know what is the value of our portfolio on the daily basis. The negatives are high risk because market is volatile in short term, can be volatile in short term, and there are some costs involved because they take management fees and there are exit loads also. For private equity, it has potential to deliver high returns in very long term, but the holding period is very long and they are not transparent because they do not have any NAV updation system. For direct shares, they are considered as growth assets, have potential of high returns. But high risk involved can be volatile, and you have to choose. You should know how to pick a share. You should know how to do a due diligence. So we have very, transparently told. We are telling in this slide what are the positives and negatives, and then according to the risk profile, we can make a portfolio. Use of technology is very important in wealth management. It is important for portfolio management to get instant information on wealth distribution, then only timely decisions can be taken. To know current portfolio value, to know returns generated by different asset class so that comparisons of performance can be made, to know asset-wise distribution of various entities as a group of group and as individuals. So it is important as we give a login ID to our clients, they know actually where the money is, in which fund it is invested, what are the returns generated by that fund. Lot of information is also available on the public domain on sites like Value Research, Money Control, Crystal, etc. Softwares are available to provide all the above information. The use of technology is very, very important. And to sum up, we understand clients' expectation and financial goals. Then we do client risk profiling and exposure to different asset class. Expert research and analysis is being done because we have a research process which Tanpa will be talking in the next presentation. Investing at good levels for increased returns. Continuous review of client portfolio and analysis for measuring deviations. And then taking adequate corrective measures for proper achievement of stated client objective. So this is our procedure and a process of wealth management. Thank you so much.